I have to sit because I have a little bit flu. Sorry. Today is a terrible day. Okay, this is the title of my talk. It's beyond query suggestions and recommending tasks to search engine user. You can see that there are many people involved in this work. We have first work with which we worked with sessionization of tasks using this concept of tasks, and also the new thing corresponding to recommendation task are not yet published. This is a submitted paper. Okay, this is another title for the same talk. Is you can see it's a combined title. We have task discovery and also task recommendation using what? Using query logs. But what is a web task? Okay, web task is a atomic user activity that can be achieved by using the web, by using also search engine, but also some other kind of services. For example, task define finder site, book a file, read news, and so on. So why we use query logs to identify web tasks? Just because people are very addicted to use web search. And so people use the web search engine for everything, also for accomplish their task. The other important thing at this point is how do we discover this web task before suggesting this task? Okay, we define this problem, a task-based session discovery, where sections are set of possibly not continuous query issued by a user whose aim is to carry out a specific web task. This is very important, non-continuous query. We argue that also there is in the also we look to the web blogs. There is a lot of multitasking, interleaving on the thing that people do before look at one task, and then look at another task, and so on. At least in a short time period. Okay. This is the big picture of our task discovery task. We have a query on Hong Kong flight, then another query flight to Hong Kong. Then NBS passport news is another task. It's not related to the first one. Pisa to Hong Kong, and then finally we can look at all these queries that are part of what we call the long-term session. You are assuming that it's possible to record all the queries that are submitted to where search engine performed by a given user. After this step, in our task discovery methods, we first split on the basis of a gap. When people stay away a lot of time without doing nothing, okay, in the query log, okay. This is a first subdivision. And then look inside this time gap session to find this kind of intertasking, interleaving task that people are performing. So this is a small time gap session, short-term session divided on the base of time, and then you can see that inside this short-term there are some kind of interleaving. The idea is to reorder these queries. that user performed. You can see the first one is query related to flight to Hong Kong. The other one is related to NBA news. The other is shopping in Hong Kong. After we recognize this special session, task-based session, we are also interested in supply novel recommendation to web search engine user on the basis of this knowledge. And then we can go from simple intra-task query recommendations. It's very common. You do a given task and then you have a specialization. A given query in a task and then you suggest, for example, a specialization on the query, for example. This is an intra-task query. To task recommendation to finally arrive at inter-task query recommendations to suggest queries that are not related to the same task. This is a new problem. Okay, we didn't find any work published about this point. So the final line of our work is to recommend another related task where the recommended one are part of the same mission. Task's mission is two concepts were suggested by Rosie Jones in CHICM. 2008, they defined a way to a supervised model to identify missions. We are not interested really in identifying missions. We recognize that there are this kind of mission. But what is a mission? A mission is a composite task. Some kind of tasks that are related but are not exactly the same. For example, each start interacting with her favorite web search engine by selecting the query or some queries. We can recognize all these queries are related to the same task. For example, task is booking a hotel room in New York. But this task can be put in a larger mission composed of many more tasks. This mission can be labeled, for example, planning a travel to New York. We have here an example. This is an example of intra-task suggestion. Suppose we can recognize that Alice is performing a query task, several queries of the same task. Related to booking hotel of New York, then we can suggest queries such as cheap New York hotels or Times Square hotel, one for Astoria, and so on. This is similar to the current query suggestion mechanism. Probably the query flow graph or the system Rafael presented before are able to do this kind of. Suggestion, but assume that discover that many users perform the tasks similar to Alice one, along with other tasks. Then these two tasks are different tasks could be part of a mission. For example, a mission concerned with planning at New York. And so we are able, for example, to segment to analyze other tasks. Use underpinning query looks like, for example, MTA subway, Broadway show, JFK airport shuttle are related to in some sense to the task that Alice is performing, but are. I'll be part of a larger mission. Okay, then the first task to arrive to this task discovery, to this task suggestion, task discovery. Okay, we use the very famous query log, the America Online query log. You can see the original data set about half million users, and we select only 1,000 users, removing a lot of things. We clean the query log, and we concentrate on only one way collection. Looking at this pretty large query log, we will see that we collected the time gap between consecutive query, and you can see that also the time gap is a distribution, a power law distribution, and we selected this time, looking at the average, the mean, also the the standard deviation, and we discovered that selecting this 26 minutes, we have that 84%, more or less, of adjacent query pairs are issued within 26 minutes. Then we decide for our first step of our method to split the query log using these 26 minutes gap. Our task discovery system then is you remember the first slide, it is subdivided in two steps. First we have time splitting, and we use also other method by anyway, for example time splitting 5 minutes, time splitting 15 minutes, but the best one was just splitting 26, and after this first time splitting, or based on the time, the idea is that it's important for us to do this before this kind of splitting, because it's two consecutive queries are far away, then are also likely unrelated, not be part of the same this task, and then after that. We adopted a query clustering, in which we used the various methods, k-means, query clustering, k-means, query clustering in DBSCAN, and two new methods that we taught in a while. The important thing is that to apply this query clustering to this method, it's important to look at two important things. One is the content of the query, the similarity between the query. This is very important. Then you use the trigrams, also use the edit distance to see if the query are similar or not from the point of view of the content. But also use it some kind of a semantic based distance. This is a combination to the distance. We call this wikification. This is a technique already used in literature. For each terms of the query, we can represent this term as a vector of the wiki the document in which the term appears. You can use also AFFADF to set this. If you want to represent a query, simply we sum the vector associated with each term, and then we can look at relatedness between two queries using this semantics. Wikipedia, also Wikidictionary, only looking at cosine similarity. Okay. We also try. This point you have a measure of similarity based on the contents of the query. Also, another similarity based on semantics. Okay. And then we can combine these two measures. You're using convex combination, but also we tried also with the conditional formula. If this means that the queries are very similar from the point of view of similarity of based on the constants, on the trigrams and so on, okay, we use the simply mu contents. Otherwise, we use also the semantics, only if the two queries are very very different from the point of view of the contents. Anyway, these two methods needs to some kind of estimation, some parameter alpha, in this case t, a threshold, bb, a factor that we multiply to the semantics. For tuning this parameter, we use the ground truth. We prepared the ground truth from the American online. What is the ground truth? Okay. Is the ground truth for us is a very short part of all the session. We of course subdivide the session using the threshold. Do some time gap session. Then we ask it to several human annotators to put together within each short session time gap session which query are part or not of the same task. Then people did clustering. Okay. Of this time-based the query, and we use this ground truth to tune the some parameter, but also most importantly to evaluate the automatic clustering for task-based session discovery we discussed above. Okay, we skip the ideas about the statistics. And okay, for the clustering we use the similarity measure we explained to you before for the various methods, but the two methods the state of the art are, for clustering came in since this is a sort of DBSCan, this density based method. But also used a new clustering based on the weighted component, weighted connected component. In a sense, is a graph based clustering. First, we build the similarity graphs in all the queries. In short term session, time gap session of each user, then build the similarity graphs. This is expensive, of course. Then we drop with edge, and then using a simple connected components is easy to identify the cluster inside. We also use another. Less expensive from the point of view of the computational time and the tail components is a simple variation of QC WCC, the previous graph based the clustering method. We call it this method TTC because we prepare the chains of queries, chains of related queries, and then we have a second. Of course, we have to drop also in this case weak edge. But the important thing to compute this chain of similar edges not important to build the complete similarity matrix. Okay. After the first phase, we have pairwise merging of the subsequent sequence to so obtained. and we do this by inserting new edge between pin and the tails. Of course, this method use as necessary to compute less similarities. We have an experiment set up in which we run. Okay, this baseline is simply time splitting. The other the query from LAF, of course. This method, but not with the query from LAF, because the query from LAF was used for several things. One of the thing was to use the query from LAF to understand when people change the task. And then use this is a supervised method which the model query for graph is used to split, simply to split, not to reorder, simply to split on the basis of the when people change tasks. Okay. Of course, we have to measure the degree of correspondence between the true task, the ground truth, of course, and the predicted task, the algorithm outputs. Of course, it's possible to use all these external measures that are used for clustering. Well, when you use a clustering method, you can use, for example, a classified data set. You can collect. You can look if the clustering is able or not to reconstruct the knowledge about the classes. For example, the F measure, we have two parts. Of course, in F measure we have precision and recall. Okay. The precision evaluate to extent to which a predicted task contains only the query of the task, and the recall you look off only if all the task all the queries of the task are presented in the cluster. Okay, this is other kind of measure that can use a simple external measure that you could look in any data mining book. Okay, we skip this. We have very good result on our ground truth in which the baseline that doesn't work very well. Query for graph work better than simple time-based splitting, but it's not able to reorder. This is a problem. Queries and then it's not able to recognize the task. K-means DB scan, the best result at this, but. Still less than the result we obtained with our two methods based on graphs and on a chain. Okay, we can look that there are a small difference, and this means the HTCC is the best one because it's less expensive. It's only based on the knowledge of the task. Then at this point we are able to perform some kind of a recommendation. We want to the our vision is that this kind of sessionization, this knowledge about the session, can be used to give novel forms of recommendation. But okay, novel forms of recommendation. We want to suggest new task and then the underpinning query that are related to the first task and are in some sense including some mission. The problem is that our segmentation. Query segmentation, query sessionization based on task-based. After this first clustering, all the tasks appear different, of course. You can look at different world, different color. User one, this is the first task, the second task, the third task, appear different. Then we need to find instead recurrent behavior in the crew. Okay, about we want to use the wisdom of pro also to understand then this kind of mission. And then we still need to identify among the similar tasks by clustering what? Clustering simply the associated with little document. Okay, we still use wiki dictionary, Wikipedia, and so on. Then we are not single query. We have a sort of virtual documents. Okay, that underpinning each of this task, and then we can cluster simply this virtual document using, for example, a cluster algorithm for tasks. At the end of this step, okay, we can rewrite each task-oriented session in terms of the new cluster, new identifier we are able to find. You look at that in the previous slide, each task has a different color. Here you can see that user 1 and user 2 probably performed a yellow task similar in some sense. Also they performed orange. Maybe if there is another user performs, for example, a yellow task, maybe we can suggest the orange one, because they occur a lot of times. Maybe in this case it's two times in the new long-term query, long-term session, the user in which we have do all this kind of transformation. What is this kind of new task identifier T1 TK? Each of these can be considered representative for an aggregation composed of similar tasks performed by several distinct users, and so on. Then we have the various long-term session here, we saw before, with the task segmentation, becomes a set sequence of synthesized tasks in which you can find, finally, recurrence. How we can find recurrence? Simply building a model, a so-called task-based model. Then we generate this task based model, simply generating a graph in which the nodes are the tasks, the synthesized task. The edge are some kind of relatedness between the task, and we have also, of course, a weight of this kind of inter-task relatedness. Of course, if they are related, we have a strong way, then they are probably part of the same mission. So remember that we are not interested in finding mission, just to suggest new tasks that probably are part of the same mission. Okay, then it's straightforward at this point. Our recommender. We have a recommender based on. The knowledge of the task. Suppose that we have a user who is interested or just perform a task TI, in this case. And TI in the model is related to several other tasks. Then we can retrieve from GT, for example, the set RM, in this case RM is R2, which include the M top related nodes with respect to T. Okay. This is a straightforward method to give suggestions. It might work. Okay. We tried with several methods to set this weight. We have of course a random base that used as baseline. Unfortunately, we don't have real baseline time for this kind of work. We have a sequence base. We don't know if you many of yours know this kind of techniques. The technique data mining technique based on the knowledge of the order of the task inside the long term. And I also we have the very common association rule based on simply the frequency, simply the confidence. The confidence is a condition of probability. On seeing both left and right when you see the left part of the rules. Okay, to test our method. We started also using kind of a user study, but okay, we don't talk about the user study. We talk about this instead to a method we use sort of how our method can be predict what the user actually did. Okay, we selected for this test from the American online query log the top 600 longest user session, and we divide this kind of longest user session into two part. The set A included 500 user section. Set B only 100 user section. The first part was used to priming our model. Okay, you have to select to have to fix the weight of each change. The other to understand if our method can be predict what the user actually do. So of course from both A and B we extracted the task with our clustering method, and the set A was used also to generate the graph model using the various technical various mining technique and so on. Now we go to how we use the subset B, our test query log. We divide each long-term session in which we already recognize the task into part, one-third the prefix and two-thirds the suffix. And the prefix is used to retrieve from GT, from the graph, the task the top in the graph with respect to the prefix. And so we should two things. One is the precision, of course. We are really interested in the precision. Okay, the proportional suggestion that actually occur in the suffix. Of course, we are not able with this test to test the serendipity of the suggestion. But we only are interested to understand which is the precision of this kind of suggestion. And also, we have the problem because several methods have several ways to select this weight. Then it's difficult to compare the various method. But then we decide to look at this discovery, the proportion of the task in the prefix that are able to provide at least one suggestion. This for each graph we are able to measure this kind of coverage. Remember that you have association rule, for example, graph in which you can change the confidence, because you can change the support, and then you have different kind of graph with much more connected graph which are less connected, and then we have to decide which is the best one. With this coverage, it's possible to compare different methods looking essentially to the potential of the various methods to give suggestions. We just plot precision versus coverage to permit a different model to be fairly compared. Okay, for medium-sized session of our test, we obtained the best result for association rule based on the frequency. Okay, the association rule based on the frequency seems the best one. Of course, in medium size, the precision is 40. For top one suggestion, large size session, of course, higher the precision because the is larger the two-thirds the suffix of the session. And okay, these are for example, these green curves correspond to the sequential mining way to fix the weight of the graph. Of course, you can see that using this method is possible to plot the different methods on the same plot. Okay, I complete the talk looking at some anecdotal evidence. We find in the suggestion we have, for example, these are the table corresponding to recommended and performance task. This is the recommendation for which the precision is good, of course, in the previous test. Okay, we are able to recognize that the given user performed the query Beach House Vanity, and then after this, he actually performed the home gardening.